Diwali's around the corner. I have created a few Diwali DIYs and I feel like I haven't done DIYs in like ages. So I'm super excited about this video. So yeah, if you want to know what all I created, please keep on watching.
For making this puja thali, you're going to need a plate and acrylic colors. So I've chosen gold and pink as my color combination. I'm going to start off by painting the outer side with gold, and I'm just going to apply like 3 to 4 coats of paint so the color is nice and opaque. For the inner circle, I'm going to paint it pink. I've applied 2 coats of paint so it is really nice and even. Then for actually decorating the plate, I've taken these pink and blue raindrop rhinestones, half cut pearl, half cut golden beads, and peppercorn. So I'm going to start off by sticking the pink raindrops first and then half cut pearls to make like an alternate design. And then I'm going to stick the blue raindrop rhinestones in between the pink ones. Now that the outer layer is completed, I'm moving on to the inner circle. So I'm starting off by sticking the half cut pearls on the edge where the two colors are being separated. After the half cut pearls, I'm going to stick the gold ones just inside the pearl ones. Then after everything is completely dried, I'm going to take 2 paint bottle caps and paint them gold and then stick it. These 2 can be used for keeping the haldi and kumkum, and there the puja thali is done. For making this tassel garland, you are going to need a bunch of tassels. I've made these from colorful wool. You can easily find a tutorial on YouTube if you don't know how to make one. Then some colorful pom-poms. And then I have this navy blue and yellow lace, a needle and extra wool. So all I'm going to do is insert the needle in the tassel and then add pom-poms to it. And just tie a knot at the back of the lace, and I'm going to repeat the same thing over and over again until I have the desired length. For making this double candle stand, I've taken a cardboard and a toilet roll. So I'm going to start off by tracing a circle on the cardboard and then cutting it. I've cut 2 pieces and the other one is bigger than the earlier one. Next, I'm just going to paint the cardboard and the toilet roll with a golden spray paint. Now that all the pieces are painted and dried, I'm going to glue the roll to the big circle first. And then I'm going to do the same with the small circle. I'm going to stick it in the center. Then I'm going to take a few plastic flowers and rhinestones to decorate the stand. So I'm going to stick the flowers opposite each other on the top circle and then stick some rhinestones around them. After that's done, I'm going to stick these half-cut pearls between the 4 flowers. Next, for the lower circle, I'm going to stick these pink rhinestones with some half-cut pearls and beads. And the stand is ready. I've placed 2 flowers on the top circle just to decorate it a bit more, and some diyas on the bottom circle to complete the whole look. Rangoli candle, I'm going to take a CD, different kinds of rhinestones, and a glass cup. So I'm going to start off by gluing the glass cup to the CD with a hot glue gun. Then I'm just going to stick these pink rhinestones around the glass cup, like so. After that, I'm going to stick these teal ones in between the pink ones. Next, I've already placed the candle wick in the glass cup, and here I have some melted wax. I've just added a blue crayon to it to make the wax look blue. And now I'm just going to pour the wax into it.
So this is it for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, then please hit the like button and comment down below telling me which DIY was your favorite. And if you recreate any of these, do send me pictures on my Instagram or Facebook. All the social media links are down in the description box. And I will see you all super soon.